So while I'm standing here trying to do a serious job, he's back here looking at reels and memes on Instagram.
Got some good ones though.
Oh, the last one you showed me, I didn't even really want to see, but that's okay. All right, so we are this week now on the brake system on this truck. What we have is we have two calipers that are dragging. Normally, if I have one caliper that's dragging, I'm going to think it's probably a problem with the caliper. That we have two of them doing it, it makes me wonder if we have something else. And what Cam's going to do next is he's going to jump in here after he puts his phone down and stops looking at reels and actually pull the master cylinder loose and pull it forward. And we'll see if that fixes our problem. We'll talk to you about why that could be the problem. And he's done it. Put your phone down.
But the memes, they must be viewed. All right. So I'm gonna take the nuts off the master cylinder mount. I'm gonna take them just to the edge of the stud. What I'm concerned about is that we may have a misadjusted push rod, or the booster may be putting some pressure onto the master cylinder when it shouldn't be. So I'm going to take these loose and pull the master forward slightly. I am doing this blind, so. There it is. Loose enough. That did push off of there. So I'm thinking we were on the right track of it not releasing completely. Now the wheel turns much easier. Let me loosen the other side up. All right, so before we loosen the master cylinder, it took pretty much two hands to move this tire. And now, light force, it's still not freewheeling, but light force and it's easy to turn. So I believe we definitely have an issue either in the booster or the push rod assembly. So we're gonna need to check the adjustments on that. But I don't think we have an issue with the calipers or the master cylinder itself. I think the master cylinder was just being held to where it couldn't release all the pressure from the front circuit. So yay, but also boo, because those two options are more expensive than the other two options. So, all right, so I am trying to measure the depth of the piston where our adjustable push rod is going to intersect with it. And I'm going to try and adjust it to where it is either just barely touching or just barely off the face of it. And we don't want to take these lines loose. They're pre-bent. We don't want to mess with it. So I'm going to use some wire stick down in there to measure the depth. This part is kind of fun because I can't get my hand in there and see what I'm doing. Or I have to do this and give the old reach around to get kind of close. So I think that is pretty close right there for the depth of the piston. And that's pretty close for the depth of the face. I'm just going to use my little piece of wire that is the depth of the piston. And I'm going to turn that rod in until it kind of lines up, and then go from there. The question is, can I put you there? Then wrap you around so that you stay. Honestly, doesn't look too horrible. just spinning in the pliers.
Hmm?
It's just spinning in the plier.
Do you want a small locking plier?
Yeah. Nope.
Is it moving?
I think so.
How much more do you have to go on it?
No clue.
That's what I like about your precision.
Well, I'm at an angle that I can't really see straight down onto it. So I can't easily tell if it's... Let's remount the master and try it there.
All right, we took the master cylinder, put it back on there, tried it again. The tires are still tight on the front end, so we're gonna have to pull a little bit more out of that push rod. One tire is not as bad, the driver's side, the passenger side is still too tight. So I gotta pull everything back off again and readjust the push rod.
All right, so we took the master cylinder on and off a few times, tightened the push rod down to shorten it, and we've got it pretty much where we're happy with it. Go ahead and give that wheel a test, Jeff.
It's better. It's still running on a pads
yeah.
A little bit. But we want to try to go ahead and get it started too to see if it's going to pull that back anymore.
Yep.
So we're going to asphyxiate ourselves in the studio now.
Oh, I love it. Switch to the other side.
Make sure it's in park.
Yes.
Let's.
The same. Brakes work.
Still think we may need to put a set of calipers on it.
Yeah, I think so too.
To caliper or not to caliper?
They're pretty cheap. I would put some on anyway.
Yeah, it's like $36 at the auto parts store to get.
Didn't
them.
We get these calipers with the beams?
No, these are actually calipers that I got from the parts store when we did it. I rebuilt everything on the front end and put new calipers on it. But I'm guessing that's maybe it, that they've been running hot for a while because that's been deployed. So it's been like riding the brakes the entire time I'm driving.
Yeah.
So that could be what's going on is they just are.
They're better. They're better. But
yeah, it's still not right, though. Yeah. It's still not right. So I have to put some calipers on it. But that's for another day.
Yeah.
So that basically shows you how to go in and diagnose if you're having a problem with the brake staying deployed on a power brake F100. You just don't know about this stuff. We found that while we were doing the I-beam setup on this truck, you know, going in and greasing the beams up on it. And then we found the fact that we had tires that were basically hardly rolling and turning. So we investigated that. That is the first thing you check. Then you go from there to putting new calipers on it if need be. As much as I've been driving this truck here lately, it's probably the calipers just need to be pulled off and at least looked at, but probably at this point replaced because they just are, they're sticking a little bit still. So that's gonna be something I'll have to do. But anyway, I know how to bleed them now. There's a video we did on bleeding. check that video out down below me here. It'll show you how to do a self-bleed by yourself. So, boom. That's how you go do that. Check that out. Shut up, man. Do me a favor, folks. Be kind to each other. Love on each other. Treat each other nice. You guys have a great week. I'll see you next time on AutoRestoMod. So now I got to go and call the parts store and wait a day for them to get the calipers in because
To get the wrong calipers.
Does it have air conditioning?
Is this a two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive? Does it have wiper blades?
Does it have AC?
Yeah.
Yes, but no. How do you tell that story on this truck?
Is there a four-year-old in the passenger seat?
Is your Wi-Fi?
What's the number?
Bye.